مثل نوره كمشكاة فيها مصباح المصباح في زجاجة الزجاجة كأنها كوكب دري يوقد من شجرة مباركة يوقد من شجرة مباركة زيتونة لا شرقية ولا غربية يكاد زيتها يضيء ولو لم تمسسه نار نور على نور يهدي الله لنوره من يشاء ويضرب الله الأمثال للناس والله بكل شيء عليم.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه وأزواجه أمهات المؤمنين وعلى من اتبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, I welcome you once again to our Wednesday edition, the Maqasidic Tafsir. Alhamdulillah, we finished volume three actually, which is the seven lengthy chapters, and we presented the subject of the Khilafah. Today, inshallah, I will begin Surah Al-Baqarah. And I will take some time with it, inshallah, بإذن الله تعالى, brothers and sisters in Islam. Surah Al-Baqarah is the summit of the Quran, Fustatul Quran. Many ahadith, narrations, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned regarding the status and the virtue of Surah Al-Baqarah. In it, brothers and sisters in Islam, the greatest verse in the Quran, Ayatul Kursi, it is the chapter which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala placed right at the beginning of the Mus'haf, in spite of the fact that it was revealed in Medina. Al-Baqarah is a Madani, and yet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala placed it in the very beginning of the Mus'haf. And Surah Al-Baqarah, brothers and sisters in Islam, is the chapter which appoints you and me to be a witnessing member of the Muslim Ummah, a witness against mankind or for mankind in this world, through the application of Tawheed, of La ilaha illallah, with the conditions we mentioned, not just a word. No, La ilaha illallah knowledge, La ilaha illallah certainty, La ilaha illallah acceptance, La ilaha illallah compliance, La ilaha illallah sincerity, truthfulness, and love. So when you implement La ilaha illallah with these conditions implemented or fulfilled or satisfied, you will then become a witness against mankind in this world. And the witnessing here does not mean that you go and you say witness. No. Is simply you established the hujjah against them. You established the evidence against them that they came across the truth, and they came across the truth through you. Again, brothers and sisters in Islam, we need to mention here that whether people accept what you're conveying or not, this is something between them and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But your job as a witness, my job as a witness, is to convey the message in the kindest manner possible, in the best way possible. That's all. That's all. اللي هي إقامة الحجة على الناس, that you establish the evidence against mankind. رسلا مبشرين ومنذرين لئلا يكون على الناس على الله لئلا يكون للناس على الله حجة بعد الرسل. And that's our duty as an ummah, the last ummah. Their messenger is the last messenger. Their Quran is the last Quran. Then you have to convey Tawheed exactly like the messengers before. You see, you need to understand something here, that the pattern in the past used to be that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would send a prophet or two or three to remind the people of Tawheed, of La ilaha illallah. And then when these messengers revive the message of Tawheed, after they disappear, whether they die or whether they depart, the message normally goes down again, meaning the people begin to forget it again. The people begin to change it. How Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would treat that? He would resurrect another messenger. He would select and choose another prophet and messenger. This pattern already interrupted with our messenger. This pattern already what? Over. Why? Your messenger is the final messenger. Your Quran, your revelation is the dominant, al-muhaymin book, the dominant book over the previous revelations. Not only that, there will be no other revelations. Now, who will convey? Is me and you. That is why this book, the Maqasidic Tafsir, is a key to understand what I'm saying to you. Brothers and sisters in Islam, it's available online for free. Just go to kareemabuzaid.com and download it. So you're getting the point here. And this is the reason why, brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala placed al-Baqarah at the very beginning. Why? Because al-Baqarah was revealed in a course of 9 years. Almost the entire Madani time. Yeah, it started early, but it kept, added stuff to it, verses to it, through the revelation, through the commands of Allah, for 9 years. But inside this surah, we have 286 verses in Surah Al-Baqarah. I hope you guys have a Quran handy, in your hand, in the language that you understand. So 286 verses. What is the middle verse? Open the Quran and look at verse 143. Look at it. You will find the appointing verse to the Muslim Ummah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is appointing them to be the witnesses against mankind. وكذلك جعلناكم أمة وسطا لتكونوا شهداء على الناس ويكون الرسول عليكم شهيدا. So Allah is appointing us to do the work of the messengers and the prophets. And this is why, by the way, we are the best ummah, because no ummah before us did that. But we're the best ummah if we do what? If we execute that. If we do this work. كُنْتُمْ خَيْرَ أُمَّةٍ أُخْرِجَتْ لِلنَّاسِ Why? تَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ المعروف is التوحيد. تنهون عن المنكر. أصل المعروف التوحيد. The origin of المعروف التوحيد. The origin of المنكر is الشرك. Origin. أصل المعصية الشرك. أصل الحسنة التوحيد. The origin of a good deed is التوحيد. Brothers and sisters in Islam, is التوحيد. The origin of shirk, the origin of sin is shirk. Amazing. أهو. تأمرون بالمعروف وتنهون عن المنكر on the basis of what? وتؤمنون بالله. And you believe in Allah سبحانه وتعالى. You're getting that, brothers and sisters in Islam. That is the key here. That is the key here. البقرة, higher aim is to appoint the Muslim Ummah to do the work of the messengers and the prophets. Again, brothers and sisters in Islam, you need to understand here. If you look carefully at the scenes of the Day of Judgment, one of these scenes is the scene of questioning. That Allah will question us. But out of the absolute, ultimate justice, fairness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, right before the questioning, Allah will ask every nation the following question: did you receive a messenger? He will ask the people of Nuh, did you receive a messenger? Someone to convey my message to you. Amazing. The disbelievers of these nations will deny. Will say no. Open the tafsir, the explanation of this verse 143 في صحيح البخاري. The book of tafsir. Or Ibn Kathir. He will mention both hadith. Musnad Ahmad and Bukhari. Sahih al-Bukhari, hadith Abi Sa'id al-Khudri, it talks about the people of Nuh, that Allah will ask the people of Nuh, did Nuh convey the message to you? They will say no. ما جاءنا من نذير. Imagine that. Nabiullah Nuh, alayhi salatu wassalam, spent 950 years, and yet they will deny that he conveyed the message to them. Then Allah will ask us, did Nuh convey the message to his people? They will say yes. That we will say yes. Allah will ask, how did you know? We read the Quran. You told us this in the Quran. This is the witnessing against mankind in the hereafter, to establish the evidence against them that they are to be questioned, that they are responsible for what they earned, for what they have in their books, whether good deeds or bad deeds. In this world, we witness with tawheed. We witness with our tawheed. That's our duty. And that's what Surah Al-Baqarah does. Surah Al-Baqarah, brothers and sisters in Islam, comes to appoint the members of the Muslim community, the Muslim Ummah, as witnessing members against the rest of humanity. Again, how do you witness? Through your application of the seven conditions of La ilaha illallah. Through living La ilaha illallah. Not hiding one of these conditions. Through living them. That is why we are the ummah of al-shahada. Ummatu al-shahada. The witnessing ummah, the ummah which will witness for or against mankind. In the hereafter, how will we witness? We will witness that all the messengers and the prophets conveyed the message to their people. What Allah instructed them to convey. That's what Surah Al-Baqarah is all about. That is why Surah Al-Baqarah comes in to lift your spirit, uplift your psychological defeat. One of the main goals of Surah Al-Baqarah is you knowing your status in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, subhanallah, brothers and sisters in Islam, even though the dua is not authentic, but there is nothing wrong with it. When he went to that trip of a Ta'if and he was mistreated, one of the things that he said, sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam, إِن لَمْ يَكُنْ بِكَ عَلَيَّ غَضَبٌ فَلَا أُبَالِي. As long as you are not angry with me, I don't care. Even if the whole world humiliates me, I really care about who am I in your sight, O Allah. Who am I? That's all I care about. You see that? When you have that attitude, brothers and sisters in Islam, you will have that spirit of winners, brothers and sisters in Islam. Al-Shahid is Surah Al-Baqarah was placed at the beginning of the Mus'haf because Muslims will be defeated psychologically when they read it. They realize that they are special in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has chosen them to convey His message, to witness, and they mobilize their forces and they begin working for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you look at Surah Al-Baqarah carefully, and again, if you have a mushaf in your hand, read the first 1 until 20. Verses 1 until 20. Surah Al-Baqarah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala divided mankind into 3 types. The believers, the disbelievers, and those who are in between. You're one of those 2, by the way. One of those 3, I'm sorry. One of those 3. Whether you're a believer, and all of mankind can be one of those 3. Believers, disbelievers, hypocrites. And subhanallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala named 3 chapters in the Quran after those. We have a chapter called Al-Mu'minun. We have a chapter called Al-Kafirun. We have a chapter called Al-Munafiqun in the Quran beside this. But these are the categories of people. Now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the attributes of each one. Now, for you to do the work of the witnesses, to witness, which group should you belong to? Hopefully, you know the answer here, that you have to be from who? From al-mu'mineen, al-muttaqeen. Alif lam mim, thalika al-kitabu la rayba fihi hudan lil-muttaqeen. Al-ladhina, then Allah mentioned their attributes. Brothers and sisters in Islam, in a nutshell, the attributes of the believers can be summed up in 4 words in Arabic. يصدقون بالأخبار ويطبقون الأوامر. is their interaction with the revelation. The revelation, brothers and sisters in Islam, the entire Quran and Sunnah, إِمَّا أَخْبَارٌ وَإِمَّا أَوَامِرٌ. Whether it is matters of unseen, أخبار, information that you cannot verify or confirm using your senses, using the sight, you cannot, something that you have to believe unseeingly, law al-ghayb, the six pillars of faith, that believe in Allah, angels, jinn, messengers, books, day of judgment, and qadr. Now, what should you do regarding those? Tasdeeq. I believe. Al-i'tiqad al-jazim. The definite attestation or conviction. I believe, Ya Rab. I don't question it. I'm not going to try to employ my intellect to understand it, to make sense of it. I can't make sense of Ya'juj and Ma'juj, so I'm going to make it zombie because I'm not getting it. La, 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 this is unseen. This is unseen. Tasdeeq. I believe it, Ya Rab, the way it is. Allah has a hand. I believe it, Ya Rab, the way that you said it, in a way that suits your majesty. فالتصديق الذين يؤمنون بالغيب تصديق. طيب, the second half of the revelation is commands. الوحي. Memorize those, brothers and sisters in Islam. If you can memorize those, you're gonna love Surah Al-Baqarah. الوحي إما أخبار وإما أوامر. الأخبار تستوجب التصديق والأوامر تستوجب التطبيق. The revelation, the Quran and Sunnah, can be whether unseen stories, unseen, صدق. I'm not going to doubt it. I'm not going to suspect it. I believe it. اللي هو علم اليقين. Or commands. Do this, do not do that. Now regarding the commands, what should you do? تطبيق. اللي هو إيه? We hear and we obey. إنما كان قول المؤمنين إذا دعوا إلى الله ورسوله ليحكم بينهم أن يقولوا سمعنا وأطعنا. That is why you see سورة البقرة started with this. Alif Lam Mim, Dhalika Al-Kitab. This book will guide those believers, muttaqeen. You can call them muttaqeen too. Number one, الذين يؤمنون بالغيب. هذا إيه؟ تصديق, right? هذا غيب. أخبار. ويقيمون الصلاة. This is awamir. We're commanded to pray five times. ومما رزقناهم ينفقون. طيب. والذين يؤمنون بما أنزل إليك وما أنزل من قبلك وبالآخرة هم يوقنون. They have certainty regarding the unseen, regarding the Akhirah. Look at this. Allah declared those to be successful already. Successful in this world. Because Allah will aid them, will give them victory. And successful in the hereafter because He will give them Jannah. أُولَٰئِكَ عَلَىٰ هُدًى مِّن رَبِّهِمْ وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ. So this is a, the first group of mankind. We ask Allah that we belong to this group, Ya Rabbil Alameen. But remember, if you belong to that group, there are duties that you have to perform. طيب, look at verse number 6 and 7, Surah Al-Baqarah. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ, the second group now, the disbelievers. Those are easy going. إن الذين كفروا سواء عليهم أأنذرتهم أم لم تنذرهم لا يؤمنون ختم الله على قلوبهم وعلى سمعهم وعلى أبصارهم غشاوة ولهم عذاب عظيم. Those who decided to disbelieve Because some people may switch things around. A lot of the people, they normally come up with the argument of al-qadr, al-jabriya, that Allah sealed their hearts. No. You see, Allah shown them the truth. They were exposed to the truth through one of the witnesses, but they decided to disbelieve. They said, we're not interested. Now, this resulted in what? In Allah sealing their hearts. So what happened first? The sealing or the disbelief? Them choosing to disbelieve. Or Allah sealed their hearts first. Which one happened first? They decided to disbelieve. Then the sealing happened later on. Those are al-kafirin. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, brothers and sisters in Islam, did not, you know, talk a lot about them. Why? Because they are clear people. You know, like a believer, the believer is crystal clear. He doesn't hide anything. I believe in this, I'm going to follow that. Believers wear the inside out. Disbelievers also wear the inside out, but the inside is terrible, which is choosing to disbelieve in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Tayyib. Comes in the third group, which وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَقُولُ آمَنَّا بِاللَّهِ وَبِالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ وَمَا هُمْ بِمُؤْمِنِينَ. The hypocrites. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about those in some details. Why? Why? Number one, they are hidden. They are not like the disbelievers. They are not like the believers. They are not straight. They are nifaq ya ikhwa. The word nifaq in Arabic is one of the root words. Also, is called in nafaq, the tunnel. What is a tunnel? The tunnel has two ends. So you come to him from this way, he exit this way. You come to him from this way, he exit this way. The Arab used to have in the desert an animal called nafaqul yarbu'. What is nafaqul yarbu'? An animal that digs two holes. Like he digs a hole in the ground and he keeps digging, and he digs a hole in the other side. So when you attack him from this side, he runs away from the other side. This animal is called nafaq. Nifaq. Hakada. They are colory. They color. You know? And those are the worst. And subhanallah, in the hereafter, we know that like Jannah are levels up, hell is levels down. Darakat. Al-Jannatu darajat, wal-Naru darakat. Hellfire is also leveled down. A disbeliever will be in a better level in hellfire than a hypocrite. قال تعالى إن المنافقين في الدرك الأسفل من النار. Indeed, the hypocrites will be placed in the lower level of the hellfire. نستعيذ بالله من النفاق. نعوذ بالله من النفاق. We ask Allah سبحانه وتعالى to immune us and protect us from hypocrisy and from being amongst the hypocrites, brothers and sisters in Islam. والنفاق يا إخوة, none of us is away from it. النفاق كما قال العلماء اعتقادي أو عملي. There is نفاق in the area of الاعتقاد, and this is what is meant in Surah Al-Baqarah here. That they claim that they are Muslims, but inside them they hate Islam and they don't want Islam. You see, al-munafiq is what? Remember when we talked about the conditions of La ilaha illallah? Al-munafiq had some knowledge. He developed some certainty at one stage. Then he accepted. Then he complies. He complies. He does the work. He prays. Al-munafiq prays. وإذا قاموا إلى الصلاة قاموا كسالى. But what they lacked, truthfulness. They are not truthful inside them. إذا جاءك المنافقون قالوا نشهد إنك لرسول الله والله يعلم إنك لرسوله والله يشهد إن المنافقين لكاذبون. They are not truthful. They are faking it, brothers and sisters in Islam. فالمنافق is now, سبحان الله, look at verse number 21. Verse number 21. As if Allah started the Quran with the following. You can be a believer, it's up to you. Remember, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted the human race and the jinn kind what we call al-amana. They say freedom to choose. Freedom to believe or not to believe. So you can be a believer. Here are the qualities. A kafir wal-ayadu billah. That's their qualities. A hypocrite. That is their qualities. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, subhanallah, is making a recommendation for you. Allah is asking you. Ya ayyuha an-nas, O mankind. اعبدوا ربكم الذي خلقكم والذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون. Verse number 21, the first call in the Quran. And subhanallah, normally the Madani Quran is known with Ya أيها الذين آمنوا, because the Quran addresses the community of believers, because the Quran which was revealed in Medina was normally about, you know, laws and commands to structure the life and the community, the individual life of Muslims, and the family life and the community life and so forth. That is why you will find Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. But subhanallah, here is the first Madani surah in the Mus'haf, and the first call, Ya ayyuha alladhina, Ya ayyuha nas, the first call, Ya ayyuha nas, O mankind. Now I want you to be from group one. I created you and this is good for you. Now, how should you do it? U'bud, engage in the commands. Engage in the commands. U'budu Rabbah. This will protect you from falling into disbelief and hypocrisy. La'allakum tattaqoon. Wadhalik, when we worship Allah, brothers and sisters in Islam, every time, We protect ourselves more from falling into hypocrisy, falling into the traps of disbelief. And this is why Ibn Abbas, for example, he mentioned that al-ma'asiyah baridul kufr. Yani if this is a statement of Ibn Abbas, as far as I remember, I could be wrong there, that sin is the envoy of kufr, of disbelief. You keep sinning until a person disbelieves. Likewise, you keep obeying until the person becomes muwahid. فَأُعْبُدُوا رَبَّكُمُ الَّذِي خَلَقَكُمْ. And right away Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is furnishing the ground on which He's commanding you to worship. Worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That He created you. And He created those who came before you. Not only you, but He created the heavens and the earth. And He brought down rain, and vegetation came out so you can nourish the body. But what about the soul? He brought down the revelation. If you question the credibility of this revelation, bring something similar to it, which you cannot do. And then Allah talks about the consequences of your decision. فَإِن لَمْ تَفْعَلُوا وَلَمْ تَفْعَلُوا. Look at verse 24, hellfire. فَاتَّقُوا النَّارَ الَّتِي وَقُودُ. You're going to become the fuel. If you choose to be a hypocrite, if you choose to be a kafir, the person will become the fuel of hell. فَاتَّقُوا النَّارَ الَّتِي وَقُودُهَا النَّاسُ وَالْحِجَارَةُ عُدَّتْ لِلْكَافِرِينَ. Then give glad tidings to the believer. That's the first star, in first rub' we call it in Surah Al-Baqarah. Give glad tidings to those who chose willingly to believe. That they will have Jannah. Subhanallah, you will have everything there. You're going to have fruits, but not the fruits of this world. Not like the fruits of this world. Then brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will then present to you three examples, three models, models, whatever you want to call it. Experimental model, cautionary, and exemplary. The first story in the Quran, the story of Adam and Satan. That Adam was the first one to be given a responsibility, like you now. وَإِذْ قَالَ رَبُّكَ لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ إِنِّي جَاعِلٌ فِي الْأَرْضِ خَلِيفَةٌ. Look at this. Now, why did I say that it was experimental? Because it wasn't really meant to last. Of course, Adam didn't know that, but obviously, if we read the Quran and Sunnah carefully, it was meant to teach Adam's offspring, alayhi salatu wasalam, Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, to teach them about the enemy, Satan. See how Satan got to your father? Do not let him do that to you. ولكن انت تعجب, there is a hadith that says, the best day the sun ever rose on is Friday. Why? ما الإلا يعني. The Prophet mentioned list of things. One of them, Adam was created on Friday. On this day he was admitted to Jannah. And on this day he exited Jannah. So what is the goodness of Adam exiting Jannah? Because Adam exiting Jannah, coming down to earth, We were with him. So what is good here for us in it? Huh? The story revealed your enemy, Satan, his tactics, how he will get to you. And what if he gets to you, like he did to our father Adam? What should you do? Because we all sinners. We all gonna fall into sin, right? None of us can maintain a perfection here. Only Allah can. Subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah is able to do that because He is perfect in His essence, perfect in His attributes and names. But me and you, we are weak creation. We're subject to sinning. Adam sinned. What did he do? He didn't do like Satan. He did not justify or make halal his sin. He said, I'm sorry, I made a mistake. Forgive me. So, the story of Adam was experimental in all aspects in order to teach us, the children of Adam, about our enemy, how he will come to deceive us, and what if he succeeds, what should we do? Because Satan will never give up, by the way, on us. Now, if you give up on Allah's forgiveness, that's a big issue. That's a big issue. Then comes in the second story. Read now. So the story of Adam is from 30 until 39, I believe. Now, read from 40, verse 40, all the way until 123. 40 until 123. This is the cautionary example. Don't be like them, Bani Israel. Ya Bani Israel, adhkuru ni'mati allati an'amtu alaykum wa awfu bi'ahdi, ufi bi'ahdikum. Bani Israel, brothers and sisters in Islam, failed in at-tasdiq and in at-tatbiq. Remember how a believer should deal with the guidance, the akhbar and the awamir. How? Al-akhbar tasdiq, al-awamir tatbiq. الأخبار that you believe it, attestation. Memorize the word attestation or conviction. الاعتقاد الجازم. The definite belief. Unshaky. Without it, beyond any shadow of doubt or suspicion that you believe something. تصديق. طب الأوامر التطبيق. Look at Bani Israel. They believe in Allah. Let's go through the six pillars of Iman here. They believe in Allah. What did they say? What did they say to Musa? وَقَالُوا لَن نُؤْمِنَ لَكَ حَتَّى نَرَى اللَّهَ جَهْرًا. We're not going to believe you, Musa, unless we see Allah. But you're supposed to believe in Allah without what? Angels. What about angels? Read the verses. قُلْ مَنْ كَانَ عَدُوًا لِلَّهِ وَمَلَائِكَتِهِ وَرُسُلِهِ وَجِبْرِيلَ وَمِيكَالَ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ عَدُوٌ لِلْكَافِرِينَ. They said that Jibreel is our enemy. A famous story that a group of rabbis came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and they said, we're going to ask you certain questions. Only a prophet would know the answer to these questions. If you answer us, we'll believe. The Prophet established a covenant with them. They ask about the first meal the people of Jannah will eat. What type of food did Yaqub, Israel, made a lawful against himself? And how a boy becomes a boy and how a girl becomes a girl after a sexual intercourse and so forth. The Prophet answered, Jibreel answered the question. Then they asked him, Man ya'tik? Which angel comes to you? They said, Jibreel. He said, oh, aduuna, our enemy. We don't like him. That's why Allah said, قُلْ مَنْ كَانَ عَدُوًا لِجِبْرِيلَ فَإِنَّهُ نَزَّلَهُ عَلَىٰ قَلْبِكَ بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ مُصَدِّقًا لِمَا بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ. Read the verses, verse 98, 97, 98. Read those. Angels. طيب. What is next? Books. What did they do with the books? They changed them. They changed the books. بِئْسَمَ اشْتَرَوْا بِهِ أَنفُسَهُمْ وَمِنْهُمْ أُمِّيُّونَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ الْكِتَابَ إِلَّا أَمَانِيَّ وَإِنْهُمْ إِلَّا يَظُنُّونَ. The books, they changed it. فَوَيْلٌ لِلَّذِينَ, look at verse 79. فَوَيْلٌ لِلَّذِينَ يَكْتُبُونَ الْكِتَابَ بِأَيْدِيهِمْ ثُمَّ يَقُولُونَ هَذَا مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ لِيَشْتَرُوا بِهِ ثَمَنًا قَلِيلًا. So the books, they changed the books. So believe in Allah, angels, books, messengers. What did they do to messengers? Read the verses what? كُلَّمَا جَاءَهُمْ رَسُولٌ بِمَا لَا تَهُوَ. Read 101. Every time a messenger comes to them with something that they do not like, read verse 87. وَلَقَدْ أَتَيْنَا مُوسَى الْكِتَابَ وَقَفَّيْنَا مِنْ بَعْدِهِ بِالرُّسُلُ وَأَتَيْنَا عِيسَى ابْنَ مَرْيَمَ الْبَيِّنَاتِ وَأَيَّدْنَاهُ بِالرُّوحِ الْقُدُسِ. أَفَكُلَّمَا جَاءَكُمْ رَسُولٌ بِمَا لَا تَهْوَى أَنفُسُكُمْ اسْتَكْبَرْتُمْ فَفَرِيقًا كَذَّبْتُمْ, فريق من الرسل, وَفَرِيقًا تَقْتُلُونَ. They killed some and they belied. They claim that they killed Jesus. We're telling them as Muslims that you guys didn't do it. So, believe in Allah, we're done with that, right? Angels, we're done with that. Books, we're done with that. What about the Day of Judgment? Some of them, they don't believe in the Day of Judgment. And those who believe in the Day of Judgment, what they say? وَقَالُوا لَن تَمَسَّنَا النَّارُ إِلَّا أَيَّامًا مَعْدُدَةً. They say, we're only going to go to hell for 40 days. The days that... we talk to worship the calf in the absence of Prophet Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. Al-Qadr, taba'an, Al-Qadr is related to the knowledge of Allah. You see, the subject of Al-Qadr has to do with the attributes of Allah. They said Allah gets tired. They say Allah doesn't know things, that you can deceive Allah. Right here, akhbar, they tab awamir, subhanallah, the commands. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala named the entire chapter after a story called Al-Baqarah. Why? Because it serves the area of the commands. During their stay in Sinai, when they were wandering around في التيه يعني a murder mystery and they are to solve that mystery because they were about to fight with one another. They are trying to figure out who killed this man. I don't want to go into the story because it's going to take a lot of my time here. And they said, why would we argue and debate when we have a messenger amongst us? Let's go to Musa. Musa is asking them, they ask Musa, can you help us out, figure out the killer? So Musa made dua and Allah said to him, ask them to slaughter a cow, command them to slaughter a cow. وَإِذْ قَالَ مُوسَى لِقَوْمِهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْمُرُكُمْ أَن تَذْبَحُوا. Quite frankly, logically, if you're going to employ your intellect with the commands of Allah, what is the connection, what is the connectivity, the relativity, the relevance between figuring out who killed a man and a cow that you need to slaughter? There is no, but who's commanding you? Allah. So there must be a wisdom. They kept saying what color, which cow. Allah is telling you, وذاك يا إخوة, the first, يا أيها الذين آمنوا in the Quran. يا أيها الذين آمنوا in the Quran. Where is it? يا أيها الذين آمنوا in the Quran. The first, يا أيها الذين آمنوا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا. Look at verse 104. Don't say the things they say. Look at verse 104. يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تقولوا راعنا. The first, يا أيها الذين آمنوا. يا أيها الناس, يا أيها الذين آمنوا. Don't say words like them. أم تريدون أن تسألوا رسولكم كما سئل موسى من قبل. Look at verse 108. Do you want to question your messenger like Musa was questioned before him? Don't do that. Don't do that. This is what we call the cautionary example. The example of Adam and his story is to learn from it. Deduce lessons from it. This one is warning. Do not be like them. Now comes in the example 123. All the way until the verse 143. Until this verse. Is the example that you should follow. Ibrahim and his family. Read 123. Read 123. وَإِذْ ابْتَلَى إِبْرَاهِيمَ رَبُّهُ بِكَلِمَاتٍ فَأَتَمَّهُنَّ قَالَ إِنِّي جَاعِلُكَ لِلنَّاسِ إِمَامًا. Aho. Be like Ibrahim, alayhi salam, and his family. Subhanallah, you know, we just explained the first juz of the Quran in Surah Al-Baqarah. Allah is presenting to you examples. One, to learn from Adam and his story. One, not to be like them, the children of Israel, the main branch, which is the Jewish community. The people who followed Prophet Musa alayhi salam and rejected Isa alayhi salatu wa salam and consequently rejecting Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa salam. And finally, the exemplary model. Follow that model. Ibrahim was commanded through a dream to slaughter his son. Imagine that. He didn't say, no, let me check that. And he actually stoned Shaitan when he tried to distract him or sway him not to fulfill the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is inshallah will continue with bi'idhnillahi ta'ala. You're going to notice now that the second half of the surah is the curriculum, the guidance. Allah revealed the foundational elements of the guidance. ولذلك, scholars said that every issue has a root in Surah Al-Baqarah, has the foundation. Allah revealed the curriculum which you're supposed to implement. When you implement it wholeheartedly, you will become a practical witness, not just words and images and that, but this is what you're also supposed to convey to mankind. And inshallah, because my Maghrib is approaching here, I have to pray Maghrib. We'll see you bi-idhnillahi ta'ala, brothers and sisters in Islam, next week. Jazakumullahu khayra. Nas'a Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala an yaj'alana min al-Qur'an wa ahli. May Allah make us amongst those who love the Qur'an and live the Qur'an, and the Qur'an is their livelihood. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, khayrukum من تعلم القرآن وعلمه. The best of you are those who learn the Quran and teach the Quran. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us of those who learn the Quran and teach the Quran sincerely for His sake, Ya Rabbil Alameen. I love you all for the sake of Allah. Till our next edition, I leave you in the care of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
الله نور السماوات والأرض مثل نوره كمشكاة فيها مصباح المصباح في زجاجة الزجاجة كأنها كوكب دري يوقد من شجرة مباركة يوقد من شجرة مباركة زيتونة لا شرقية ولا غربية يكاد زيتها يضيء ولو لم تمسسه نار نور على نور يهدي الله لنوره من يشاء ويضرب الله الأمثال للناس والله بكل شيء عليم.